The Barbican Art Gallery is host to a major retrospective of German artist John Hartfield, who in the 20s and 30s developed a new way in which to present photography called photomontage, which he went on to use as a startling and provocative weapon.
What I find so intense about them is there's nothing between you and it. It absolutely gives you the main line. You know, it's like a mainline injection or something. And that is exactly what is happening, what you're seeing in front of you. And it's not some artist's impression of something happening. It's real.
I admire this guy because he really has a lot of content and has refined the images. And he virtually single-handedly invented photomontage.
Along with fellow Dadaist George Grosz, Hartfield constantly attacked an odious bourgeois society. This period formed the basis for his later work, which, directed by his communist beliefs, led him in an artistic crusade against the all-powerful Third Reich.
How would you feel about trying to do this kind of image with that kind of social atmosphere that was around during the 20s and 30s? And doing it, knowing the consequences of it, I wonder whether we have guts enough to do that today. I don't know. This is really gutsy stuff.
He was 100% committed, but by his heart. He was politically naive. His commitment to socialism or communism or whatever you want to call it was that of a man who loved, committed to justice, and he hated all extremism.
During his lifetime, he was dismissed and disregarded by the art establishment as a mere propagandist. Hartfield's reconstituted photographs stuck in the throats of an art world who refused to acknowledge his political commitment and originality.
His work isn't propaganda because it's about actually making people think critically about things. It's not saying, go and do this, join that, you know, other than in a few posters for the Communist Party. It's about saying, think what's happening, see what's happening.
This stuff is very much a part of the art, the real art of the 20th century. This is the art. This is the face of art of the 20th century.
The exhibition confirms the importance of Hartfield's work, which has gone on to influence everything from high art to punk rock.
Hartfield did all this stuff long before, you know, we started cutting out pieces of paper and making them wiggle around. And I begin to feel like a copyist when I come into plays like this.
I think the collage thing was very, very much using the whole punk thing early on. I mean, I did loads of collages for the gigs and just printed them up, stand outside clubs, giving them to people and to get them down to the marquee to see us.
Images, they transcend the topicality, not all of them, but many of them, and they're reused by people. I mean, a lot of these images in here, if you're not familiar with Hartfield, they'll feel vaguely familiar, because people still use them.
He risked his life to make the images he did, and he struggled against fascism. He's an incredible example to create, you know, to everybody. That you can use your visual language to as a form of struggle.